and say this while you pray. Lord, I may not be what you want me to be, but I sure ain't what I used to be. Come on, give yourself a hand for that. Amen. That's called progress. Amen. Amen. That's called progress. Amen. That's called getting better. Amen. That's called striving. Amen. That's a pursuit of perfection. And I ain't talking about no Lexus. I'm talking about being Christ-like. Amen. It's a pursuit of perfection that we must continue to pursue. We cannot stop trying to be like Christ. Amen. We have to continue this until we get it. Amen. Until he comes back while we're trying. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. Let's get in the word. Amen. 2 Samuel chapter 22, verses 21 through 25. Amen. 2 Samuel chapter 22, verses 21 through 25. Amen. It says, the Lord has dealt with me according to my righteousness. According to cleanness of my hands, he has rewarded me. For I have kept the ways of the Lord. I am not guilty of turning from my God. All his laws are before me. I have not turned away from his decrees. I have been blameless before him and have kept myself from sin. The Lord has rewarded me according to my righteousness, according to my cleanness in his sight. Amen. Somebody say amen for God's word. Amen. Praise God. With that, amen, I like to talk about how we have a saying with the little Pee Wee League football team that we have. We like to say that hard work pays off. That's what we like to say. We like to say hard work pays off, amen. But David is in the midst of his praise in 2 Samuel here. He's singing praise songs to God, and in the midst of his praise, he wants us to know that living right is what pays off. Living right, amen, is what pays off. So I would like to reiterate what David says today, and I would like to talk about the fact that living right pays off, amen. Many of us say and many of us believe that hard work pays off, but it depends on what you're working on. Amen. Some people are working hard on some things, amen, that's going to be a detriment, amen, which is going to be the death of them or the downfall of them, amen, because everything you work on is not right. Amen. You know, you got some hard-working drug dealers, amen, and some hard-working criminals, amen, that get up early to perfect their craft, amen, because that's what they do, amen. But their hard work will not pay off for them because their hard work is not righteous work. Amen, somebody. So we gotta be careful that we're not just working hard unless we're working hard to maybe work out our salvation. Or if we're working hard to live for God. If we're working hard in those things, then trust me, as David has said today, then yes, hard work will pay off. But David talks about how God has dealt with him or deals with him according to his righteousness. And he's being rewarded according to the cleanliness of his hand. And the thing about it is that the devil does not want us to connect these dots. Amen. One of the most elementary type of activities that you can do in school is to connect dots. Amen. I remember when we were in kindergarten, first grade, I don't have time for this kind of stuff now, but they would give us this picture and we couldn't tell that it was a picture. Yeah. And you couldn't tell it was a picture until you connect A to B and B to C and C to D. And after a while, by the time you get to P, you're like, oh, this is a balloon. You know, and you can almost see the picture as you begin to what? Connect the dots, amen? Because that's an elementary fundamental, connecting dots. This is a concept, or this is an ability that the enemy has taken away from Christians. That we cannot seem to connect simple dots. Amen? That righteousness connects directly to blessings. That living right connects directly to being paid off by God. It is hard for me to understand why people cannot connect to God. That if I live according to God's word, and I live for God, then God is going to bless me, amen, according, amen. This is a simple fundamental. Somebody say connect the dots. The enemy don't want us to be able to connect this dot. Amen. That God deals with us according to our righteousness. He deals with us according to our cleanliness of our hands. Amen, somebody. In other words, I've heard people say things like this before, that God don't bless no mess. And I understand that sometimes we do live off the deception of the devil. Amen. That the enemy does bless you with temporary things. Gratification is a temporary thing, and the devil have a lot of gratifying gifts that he gives that will not last. Amen. That they are temporary things. But they have a deception to them that when he's giving them to you, that you're okay because you have them. Like somebody who may be selling drugs feel that he is being blessed because he's living good. He got cars and rims and money and female. And at the time, he feel like, oh, I'm being blessed. I'm living good. But when the ATF and when the FBI and when all of these people kick in his door, then a reality set in that everything that he had last night and before was temporary. And that now he has to pay the piper. His soul is going to be cashed in now to what he has sold to the enemy. Because anything that the devil gives you is going to cost. But God, somebody say with God. But God says that if you live a certain way for me, I'm going to always take care of mine. Living right will definitely pay off. It's good to be able to praise God. But it is awesome to be able to praise God, remembering and experiencing his mighty acts. In other words, you're not just praising God in unison. Or you're just not praising God in participation. But you're praising God in all of what he has done for you. Amen, somebody. You know what happens when you get into a dynamic praise service? When you have everybody that's praising God on one accord about so many different things that he has done in that one place. Because you're not praising God because your neighbor is praising God, but you're just simply praising God because you know what God has done. Amen, somebody. You're celebrating God. You're celebrating what he's done. Psalms 106, 2 and 3 talks about the ability to be able to praise God with this in mind. Who can proclaim the mighty acts of the Lord? Or who can fully declare his praise? Who's able to stand up and really just give God praise even if the piano breaks? Even if the drummer don't show up? Yeah, all we got is a tambourine, and we got to get a foot going. And everybody can get on meet and begin to praise God. Who can proclaim it? Those people who are living right. Why? Because they have experienced his mighty acts. Blessed are those who act justly. And who always do what is right. It's plain as day. Blessed are those who always do what is right, not do what they feel like. Not do what they feel like. Not do what is right on Sunday or church day, but always do what is right. Not do what is right when somebody is looking or somebody is listening. Not do what is right when they're in town.
But do what is right also out of town, like they do in town. Does that make sense yet? Doing what's right outside of their parents' supervision. Just like they do what's right in their supervision. Why? Because living right is going to pay. Ask yourself, do I praise God because the piano playing, or do I praise God because I know what he's done?
Yes.
See, that's the question. Do I have something to praise God about? Is praising God an easy thing? Somebody said, let's get up and praise God. Am I first to stand up? Because in my living, God is doing so much for me. I remember when I first started church, praise was annoying to me. Because I was under the impression that church should be comfortable. That I should be able to come into service and sit down and listen. And when everybody kept jumping up praising God, it was annoying to me. But I'll be honest with you, I didn't have a whole lot to praise them about. You know, I could have thanked them for letting me wake up and see another day. I could have thanked him for letting me be clothed in my right mind. Yeah. But my goodness, cats and dogs woke up this morning and got their fur on. Squirrels got acorns. Amen, somebody. Amen. We shouldn't have to scrape down for some old talking about, I just thank the Lord that I can stand up. Crutches stand up. Canes stand up. But we want to be able to praise God and say, for mighty acts, for when things go down in our life, we say, oh, God is just so good. Amen. Because it's a mighty act. It ain't something that's just given to any old. A fly got up and flew this morning. Amen. A mosquito hatched from the water this morning. But I'm talking about a mighty act. Amen, somebody. And who in here can proclaim God's mighty act? You want me to give you the answer? Those who have chosen to live right. Praise God, somebody. I'm trying to connect the dots to them. That living right pays off. There's a young couple that decided that they were going to live right. And the young lady spearheaded. Amen. It was in her heart that she loves God more than the feelings. And she decided that they gonna do this thing right. I'm talking about cut them off.
Oh yeah, come on now.
That's it. We gonna do this thing the right way. And the enemy got busy. People started asking her. Not just any people, but like pastor-wise and so-called Christian people. Asking her, why would you choose to do that? You gonna mess around and lose him. Yeah, help us, Lord. But she decided to stick with him. Amen. And in two weeks, we're sitting there, she said, well, you know, I just want to share with you that my supervisor called me into the office. And they began to say, so I guess with some other people, that they had been watching me and that they were going to give me a promotion. That they were training me for a position that had been posted yet. Say that, we ain't posted it yet. But we're going to train you for it. So when it comes, you get it. Come on, somebody. So the captain is in there with us saying, yeah, he's going down here. You know, I got a new job, too.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. He probably wasn't happy about the decision, but living right pays off. It's a dot that's connected there. That's why God said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, then I will heal them. Psalm 37:3 talks about the fact that we got to trust in the Lord and do good. I like that. Trust in the Lord and do good. Now, a lot of people trust in the Lord, but ain't trying to do good. If you trust in God and it ain't doing good, what you trusting him for? That's scary. Trusting that his word is going to be true. And there's a lot of people that's doing good, but ain't trusting in the Lord. Now watch this. See, because doing good, you got people that give to charities. You know, they're very charitable. You know, they feed anybody. Amen. They give their last. They do all of this stuff, but they live any kind of life. But there's a connected again that we got to trust in God and we got to do good. Then we can dwell in the land and enjoy safe pastures. King James Version says something like, "And thou shalt be faithful," which means that thou shalt be blessed all the time. That shall not work for anything. Uh-huh. If you trust in God and do good. Yes. So we got a young lady here that has decided, and I think it's been a fight, but thank God for fights.
All right.
Especially those that you stay in win.
Yeah.
She's going to live right, but then she's going to trust God and go a step further, and she's going to go to ministry school. To support the decision of living right. Because sometimes we can decide to live for God, but don't get in his word and understand why we're living while we live. How we live. Don't get in his word and get distracted to live like we should be living. And in the decision and the dot connecting of living right and trusting God, they begin to pray for a job in their career. I've heard you before say there's such thing as a job and there's such thing as a career.
Amen.
Amen. And the Lord put it on our heart to inquire about a career job. Mm-hmm.
Right.
And he put it in our heart on due season. Because when she asked somebody about it, the next day somebody told them about it. And so the next day they called her about it, and within a few days she had that particular job in her career. That you work for so long and then you get 3-4 hours just to do nothing. So you can study your ministry school. Amen. That's what you call I'm going to put you in a safe place. I'm going to put you in a place in me where whatever you need, amen, I will provide. I will feed. See, a lot of us don't know what it feels like to be in a safe place. That baby is in a safe place. I just noticed just a second ago, she was giving her her bottle. Now she's holding her. She's going to burp her. She's going to care for her. She's in a safe place.
Amen.
And when she gets home, they're going to lay her down somewhere where she cannot hurt herself.
Amen.
Amen. And God is going to keep us in a safe place. Where he can feed us and hold us and put us in places where can't nothing go on us. But we got to live right. We got to do what's right. That's going to pay off. Amen, somebody. So Psalms 37 talks about this safe place. But in Proverbs 13:21, it gave us a new perspective on what is being said. It says, trouble pursues the sinner, but the righteous are rewarded with good things. We have to understand that trouble is what pursues sinners. Somebody say it, trouble pursues sinners. I'm so glad for God's word because somebody would have thought I was just making this. Trouble pursues sinners. That's what's behind you when you're not living right. Trouble is behind you Anybody ever look back because you thought something was behind you? Baby, if you're not living right, you keep looking just like that. Every so many feet, every so many hours, you just gonna start looking back. Because the Bible is teaching us that you might not be able to see it, but it's there, it's behind you. Trouble is behind you if you're not living right. Paranoia, y'all know what that is? When you're paranoid, paranoia comes with not living right. Something is behind you. But the words say, but the righteous are rewarded with good things. So the Bible tells me when I started living right, it says mercy and goodness got behind me and began to follow me all the days of my life. And I didn't have to look over my shoulder no more. I just know that something good is right behind me. Is that not what the word says? So here's the question, what's following you? What's behind you? Is trouble behind you? Or is God's mercy and goodness behind you? Living right pays off. Amen, somebody. So we got to understand that the righteous are rewarded with good things. T.J. said it best the other day. He says, God goes to and fro, looking for people that he can bless. That's the kind of God we serve. It says God searches and seeks people that he can bless. Somebody thank God I'm not being like your mama was in the old days. Mama give me a dime, I ain't giving you nothing. God is not that kind of God. He's not a stingy God.
I know somebody, when they first got saved, they burned over 100
and 50 or 250, 300 CDs. I mean, all from Tupac to Spice One to all the old school stuff some of y'all don't know about. He said he had to burn all of them.
Yeah.
And that was part of his training, because he knew that as long as that stuff was around him, he would be too weak to not listen to it. So part of his training was to burn that stuff.
Yeah.
He had to get rid of it. And he said, I wasn't going to give it to nobody, because I wasn't going to mess nobody up like it had already messed me up.
Yeah.
So somebody had to go home. They got to burn their CD. You got to burn your flicks.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I had a little bit. I thought it worked for 40, but it was all flicks in there. And if he gonna come to Jesus, and if he gonna live right, he gonna have to have a burn. Amen, somebody. He gonna have to train himself to get away from that stuff. Amen. And then he gonna have to do what's necessary to keep himself away from that stuff.
Yeah.
Got a burn. Or we have to get away sometimes. I just disappeared from the fraternity when I first got saved. Got away. Got away from all that mess. Got away from hanging out. Got away from clubbing. And got away from anything that would interfere. That's a good word right there.
Yeah.
But what I'm trying to be in God. Those were interferences.
Yeah.
And I was training myself to live a certain way. So I was just cutting things away. And it comes a time when God grow you up and send you back to what you cut out.
Right.
Now I can go hang around the bros and bros ease up too. Man, I just got to holler at you. Working with you. Well, come on, brother, let's talk. Amen. Amen. Y'all be throwing yours and breaking new dukes and all that. It don't even faze me. Amen. Y'all be praying and shimmying. Amen. And I'm all good.
Yeah.
But it was a time I couldn't have done that. Does that make sense? It says that for physical training, it's for somebody.
Yeah.
Zumba helped somebody last night. That had somebody to it. To burn that many calories, that had somebody to it. But God in this training, it has a value for all things.
Amen.
It holds a promise for both this present life and the life to come. That's the connection of God. If you train yourself to live right, you get promises for right now, and then you got a promise for when you get out of here.
Lord Jesus.
I don't know about y'all, but I want all my promises.
Amen.
Amen. My wife can't promise me nothing that I don't want to look for. If she tell me I'm going to get it, I want it.
Amen,
somebody. And God has promised us some things, amen, and I don't know who in here would not want what God has promised them.
Amen,
somebody. God has promised us some things, and I don't know who in here would not want what he has promised us. So we got to fully accept this. What do we have to fully accept? We got to accept the fact that living right pays off.
Amen.
So we got to be careful with man's law. Because it's not against the law to cheat. It's not against the law to cheat. No man has been to jail for cheating on his wife, nor has a woman went to jail for cheating on her husband. So you have to be careful that you don't get caught up in the world's law. The world writes its laws to be different. Amen, somebody. It's not illegal to be homosexual. Matter of fact, they write in laws so that you can be. And you got to be careful that you don't get caught up in these particular laws. Because these laws are the laws of the enemy that has been written to directly disconnect us from the blessings of God. Amen, somebody. Not a sin in fornication. careful that we don't get caught up in what the world says is right versus what God says is right. We got to live for God. As I close with the Deuteronomy as my backdrop. How I say it, babe? It's not a sin in front of them. Oh, yeah. It's a sin in front of them.
Can't walk around here knowing that God got things for me up there, and all
He's going to start showering down to me. Somebody got to be outside of their mind, not to live right for God. Because living right is got to pay off. God said, I got to hear me with somebody's name on it. I got a deliverance with somebody's name on it. I got prosperity with somebody's name on it. I got a brand new business with somebody's name on it. I got a happy marriage with somebody's name on it. Am I talking to anybody? I got good health with somebody's name on it. Come on, somebody. You ought to make up your mind. I'm going to live right. I got my name on it. Am I talking to somebody? Living right. We will pay off. God is in the blessing business. He said, I'll bless all the work of your hand. If you grow greens, you have muscles all over your place. If you work on something, it's going to be good no matter what you do. God said, I'll bless the work of all our hands. We're going to be lenders and not borrowers. Pay their loan, come and borrow from me. Am I talking to somebody today? Because you done borrowed your last week. God said, I'm going to put you in a place where people come to you and ask you for money. Don't get frustrated when they start calling you up. Just know that they know that God done bless you. Amen. And they know where they can get a 20 from. And they know where they can get a 100 from. Come on, somebody say, I'm a lender and not a borrower. He's going to make us the head and not the tail. And we gonna always be on top and not on the bottom. Them young folks like to sing a song and say, I started from the bottom, but now I'm here. I don't know where you are, but I ain't where I used to be. I used to be on the bottom, but I'm coming up in God. I might not be on my mountaintop, but I'm on the side of God's hill, and I'm coming on the good side. Where there's green pastures, come on somebody, get off the bottom of what you mean and get on God's top. Am I talking to somebody? But if we gonna be blessed, we got to turn. We cannot turn. We cannot turn aside from God's word. We cannot go to the left, nor can we go to the right. But we got to live according to God's word. All God's commandments. We got to keep all his precepts.